Welcome to another edition of About Town, the program that takes you to special places throughout Ventura County, places where you can discover our unique heritage. We are here at the historical Olivas Adobe to understand the role of the Olivas family and their contribution to Ventura's history. My name is Richard Serrett. And I was a volunteer here. I actually managed the Olivas Adobe for many years. I managed to learn a great deal about this family and their role in the development and settlement of what is today the city of Ventura. Right behind me is their beautiful rose garden. It was a status symbol to have beautiful roses to impress people with their smells and their beauty. And the more exotic, the more expensive, and of course that reflected on a person's status and wealth within the community. One of the reasons we're here is because of the owls that have just hatched a new nest of chicks. The owls have their nest in a large eucalyptus tree, and every year the Olivas Adobe has an owl festival where owls are celebrated, and the Raptor Center of Ojai come and talk about saving these magnificent birds. They actually go out, rescue the owls, rehabilitate them, and release them into the wild. The Raptor Center also has an educational program where those owls who are unable to be released because of their age or infirmities become ambassadors, where they take the birds to the schools to teach about these unique raptors. That's a great program and one that helps to enlighten school children about the importance of the owl family and other raptors that fly. When we get back, we'll be interviewing one of the volunteers here at the Olivas Adobe, a woman with a very special link to this unique house. Thank you for joining us. We'll be right back. Historic landmark number one for Ventura County, Olivas Adobe. This two-story Monterey-style adobe was the center of Rancho San Miguel in 1841, land grant, built between 1847 and 1852 by Don Raimundo Olivas, a prominent cattle and sheep rancher. The adobe was owned by the family until 1899. Restored in the late 1920s by millionaire Max Fleischmann of Fleischmann's Yeast and Margarine, he used it as a hunting lodge. The historic house has been given to the city of San Buenaventura in 1963 and designated as a historic landmark on February 11th, 1974. Now a historic museum, it is dedicated to Ventura's Rancho heritage. This is a historic gate at the Olivas Adobe. It's really not that historic. It was built back in 1929 by the last owner of the place, a man named Max Fleischmann, who gave it to the city of Ventura. He thought it looked very Spanish. He was a great lover of the missions. The gate is actually patterned after a mission gate. The bell itself is actually from an old steam engine. It used to be on the front of a locomotive, but he brought it in there, and of course, the Olivases had a bell, not that fancy maybe, but they took it with them when they sold the house. So it's not the original bell. I have no idea what happened to the original. This is a courtyard where they hold their big Music Under the Stars event, where people dance and enjoy the beautiful surroundings all evening long. It's really a great deal of fun. You can bring your own picnic for that, or your own bottle of booze even. It's legal here at that particular event. The main hacienda is large, and it's a two-story affair, and it certainly needed to be because Raimundo and his wife had 20 Hmong children. In fact, it was even bigger a long time ago. Some parts of the house have not survived. There's about 7 bedrooms that are missing from the house. This is what Max Fleischmann restored for his own use, and that's what was given to us. But it was really bigger a long time ago. This was the center of social life in the Santa Clara Valley. They had parties that could last for days on end. They hung lanterns on every balcony. And we have newspaper accounts of the hospitality and the parties held here at the Olivas Adobe. Welcome back to the program. We're with one of the volunteer docents here at the Olivas Adobe who has a unique connection to this house. Georgia is your name?
Yes, Georgia Marie Olivas Madrid.
So you're an actual descendant of the house?
Yeah, I'm a direct descendant to the Olivas family in Adobe.
And how long have you been a docent?
This is my second time volunteering. The first time I volunteered for a couple years and then moved, and then I'm back, and now I've been a little over a year.
Oh, right. What can you tell our audience about what it's like to be a volunteer out here?
I love it. They're almost always surprised that there's still a living Olivas. And how they respond is very kind, thrilled to meet me, as I am to meet them also. So we feel the same. It goes both ways.
What is the history of this house that you tell visitors?
The history of the house is that I never say my great-great-grandfather. I talk about Don Raimundo and Teodora as if in the first sentence of saying that they're my grandmother and grandfather, and the languages that he spoke and how he wrote up the land grant and the patent in order for them to have the land and secure it for my grandmother. And they had 21 children, and the second generation had 42. And how appreciative I am from the Fleischmann set that owned the property and who gifted it to the city so I could be here today.
Well, that's so great.
I'm very blessed.
And now, you work out here. What kind of events do they have here at the Adobe? Okay. What's coming up?
So they're having at Mother's Day in May, Murals and Roses. It's a very beautiful event, and you can see earlier where you saw the roses. And then in July 14th, it starts, is the Music Under the Stars. That is fabulous. I worked it last year, and I want to work it every year. It's just so wonderful. The bands are great. Music is wonderful. And they dance from the time it starts to the time that it ends. And then the other events are, we're always looking for new volunteers for the Olivas Adobe. There's some training, but it's not hard, and it's wonderful, and become very knowledgeable in that process. And then also, I'm working with two docents right now. One is Marilyn, and she's been a docent here at the Adobe for 15 years. And the other lady's name is Rosie, and she's been working here for over 11 years as a docent. And when we have to be at events and we need to have my grandmother and grandfather come, she plays and her husband play Don Raimundo and Teodora, which I just love. They're really great people, and I'm very blessed. They're retired school teachers, which is mostly what they are here, is retired school teachers.
Well, it makes sense. They want to teach and keep alive the history of... So you're out here today meeting the public. What are you going to be doing? Giving tours?
Yes. What I do is, what I'm mainly here to is to volunteer, is for tours and anything that they may need me for. We also put placements out, and that's the cowhide that you see to my left. You see that a branding iron, that's how they brand the hide, as well as they show an example of candles that they make here at the Adobe, as well as bars of soap. I don't think it's a bar of soap I would use personally in today's society, but I'm sure that it was very wonderful at that time and period.
It was made out of cow fat.
Yeah. Oh, is that
and,
what
you mean? Tallow. And you could burn it as a candle, or you could use it to grease the wheels of your car, or even wash yourselves off, though it leaves kind of an awful skimmy stuff. Yeah. So you had only two kinds of soap. Lye, made out of ashes, which was very harsh. It'd clean you, but also take your skin off. And you had tallow soap. Now, how much does it cost to come out to the Olivas Adobe?
It depends on the size of the family, but it's $5, $10 for a family. And we send you away with a calendar and a diagram of the Adobe, and that's a gift from us. And we have a gift store here that has the most adorable, nice vintage as well as Victorian pieces that we're selling here, and our owlets, they're darling. So do come in, it's wonderful to visit here.
I know they've got some things there that you can find nowhere else.
Really then?
Some of the books I've written.
Oh yes, sale. Of course. I love it particularly, believe it or not, is the Chillon's color book.
Yes. I have one that deals with ghosts and legends as well as history books. One about the family. One of the few books on the Native California family that's in existence, the Olivas family.
I agree.
We have a lot of kids coming out here. I know.
Yeah, I know. I love
here
that.
Here when Candace Bergen brought her daughter here.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah, I'm sure of it.
And they actually did our award-winning Rancho program that's won two state awards under a stiff competition all over California here at the Adobe. We were the first to have such a program where the students learn how to make Adobe bricks.
And the next time we have a fiesta, and they're going to do that. That's what I want to do, is make some bricks.
The bricks, it's a little messy.
That's
but
all right.
The kids love it. They still do
they
the mud pit in our award-winning Rancho program. And it's still very popular. There's a long waiting list of people, and they come from as far away as L.A. and Santa Barbara.
That's right.
To have this unique experience here at the Olivas Adobe.
And they also learn about the history in the fourth grade, I believe. California history, am I correct?
Yes, they learn of the history of the family as well as the Rancho era.
Exactly.
And how it contributed to California's history and about this unique family. If anyone would like to participate in this program, how can they get on the list, the long waiting list, to become part of the Rancho program?
They can call the city, ask for Gina, and she'll be more than glad to set you up and do whatever it is that needs to be done. Gina is from Parks and Recreation, really a wonderful lady. She's been working for the city for quite a few years, and she just about knows everything,
yeah,
or does know everything.
She can set everything up for you.
Yes, exactly.
She's a wonderful lady, and it's a great program. Yeah. And the fact that people keep coming over and over again, once they do it, it's on their list to come back again.
And before I forget, I was looking at our brochures, but you also can rent the Adobe for the day, in particular for weddings, for quinceañeras. And the only Olivas that was married here on the Adobe was my nephew Evan and his wife Connie. I think they've been married about 30 years now, 25, 30 years.
Yeah.
Actually a little bit more than that. And it was exciting to be here. To share that. And it was, I believe, my cousin, Father Bill Olivas, that married them. And he's the only one that I'm aware of that is a priest.
Yes.
That is an Olivas and became a priest.
Yeah, that was the family's goal, was to have a priest.
That's
in the family. They finally got their wish.
I know, we
and
all
Bill's
did.
Bill's a wonderful guy.
I know. He worked in Ojai. He's now deceased, but a wonderful, kind, gentle man.
Can we look at your table display?
Absolutely.
See what you've got for the public?
Absolutely.
So this is set out. It's a cowhide, right?
Yes.
And that's a ritual
it's
steer.
A real...
Of course, this was a cattle ranch.
And right here is the...
The brand?
The branding iron.
This is the original Olivas brand. Right here, that they had to identify their cattle. Here's an example, you can see
okay,
it better.
Here we go.
Yeah, I did the research on that and managed to find the branding mark. So that is the original brand.
Oh, how exciting.
We always thought it was a big O or something, but it wasn't.
But it wasn't, no, that's why I wasn't sure. And then this is the soaps that they make,
yeah,
that you were explaining earlier.
Yeah, tallow soap. Really, this isn't ivory. This is pretty rough stuff,
yeah.
But it does work as soap.
Imagine they wash the babies in this, oh my gosh.
And then they had candles that they could make. This was kind of broken, but
yeah.
All you needed was a wick and you dipped them. And these work as good as any candle they had, and this is what they had for illumination. Do you have a candle making program here?
Right now, no, and I don't know if they're going to be joining in the near future. Because I believe you just said, Richard, that it was real hot, and it was too hot for the children to touch, so they thought maybe it'd be too dangerous for them.
Yeah, it might burn them. Yeah, that's what's
their fear.
It might
burn them, of course.
Even though it's really fun, because it takes so long. You got to dip them, and then let them cool it. Dip them about 25 times.
Oh, my gosh.
You make a nice candle. It works, but it's time-consuming.
Oh, let me ask you, Richard, do they have tanning classes here?
No, they don't have
They don't tanning. Have anything like that?
No, we don't need the tanning is a very involved process. It involves scraping off all the meat and then treating it with not-so-pleasant materials like urine. Mm-hmm. And they smelled, but it works very well.
At that time.
Yeah, it still does, by the way. Work well. This has been tanned using a modern process.
See here, look at the, it goes through the other side, is the branding.
Yeah, you can see the brand marks. People say it doesn't hurt the cattle, but I disagree.
Richard, do you know where the cattle come from?
I think the cattle they had here were longhorn steers at the ranch, but this hide is probably more from a heifer, and probably it comes from northern Mexico.
Oh yeah, that's where they come out of, because they're known, notoriously famous for them. They are notoriously famous for wonderful hides.
But they made all sorts of things out of the leather, from shoes to hats to belts to saddles.
Mm-hmm.
You name it, they made it out of leather.
That's right. Jackets, vests, pants.
Yeah. Can we visit the tree where the owls are nesting? It's a big eucalyptus, right?
Yes, it is.
Okay, and lead the way.
Okay, I'm so excited to go with you. She's been here probably for at least a month, if not more. And she's had two babies, and she's up there with her babies now.
Yeah, and guess what? You don't want to ever mess with the owls when they're doing this, because Mama will not like it. Why do the owls live here? Because our neighbor is a big golf course. Uh-huh. And at night, they swoop down and eat the golfers. Well, beyond the golf course is the fields where they grow things over here, as well as the river bottom and the delta of the Santa Clara River. So they have lots of food to eat, and we know what they eat because they drop pellets. They can't digest their meals, and so they spit them up, and we can look at their owl pellets and figure out through the bones what they're munching on. And what are they munching on?
Yes, I'd like to know.
Gophers, mostly gophers.
Really? Now,
they also eat rodents, any rodents, lizards, anything like that. And of course, the river bottom has all sorts of animals.
Yeah, they have a lot of them.
But from the owl pellets, the vast majority of what their diet consists of is gophers. And the gophers come out at night thinking they're safe in the dark. But the owls can see in the dark, and they have silent wings. No one knows they're there. In fact, they can swoop down, making no sound, catch the gopher, and of course, that's dinner for him.
It's dinner for now.
Georgia, how was the attendance at the Owl Festival last week?
It was huge. It was huge. What I loved is there was all these little boutiques that were up, all related to owls, and artwork, which was beautiful, and then the Adobe was open so that they could visit it. We didn't do dosing because it's too hard to do private dosing, but we were there just to watch and to guide them and answer any small questions that they may have. Ojai Raptor Center is a wonderful organization, and we had chairs set out so that people could come and just circle them to see the animals. And it was just completely filled. Probably well over 100 people.
Over 100?
Oh, yeah,
that's great.
At least.
Now, you have this event every year. Usually, when does it fall?
Yes. Every year in April, I believe.
So it's the early part of April.
Yeah, yes, it is.
It's well worth it. Does it cost to go to it?
No, there's no charge to get in.
Of course, the next one we have coming up is Murals of Roses.
Yes.
What in the world's that about?
You know what? I haven't been to one because I'm always gone on Mother's Day, but I'm going to try and make it this coming year to enjoy it and be able to share with you what it's really about. But I said to exhibit the roses and the celebration of Mom on Mother's Day.
Oh, so it's a Mother's Day event.
It's on a Mother's Day event.
And they have all the murals painted by a local artist. It's just really a beautiful
event.
Well,
in the exhibit hall, we have these amazing murals. They're huge, but they're of the Rancho days at the Olivas Adobe, and they're beautiful.
Well, thank you for talking to us and giving us a brief description of this unique spot here in Ventura County.
Thank you for allowing me to join you, Richard. You're such a wonderful person to be with And it's like I leave here with a book of knowledge, and I thank you for that.
Thank you. Oh, if people want to become a volunteer docent here or donate to the Olivas Adobe Volunteer Historical Interpreters, how can they do that?
I believe that they come here to the Adobe, or they call here, and then set up an appointment, and then we can meet with them, and somebody here will set that up for them.
Oh, I'm sure. Now, you're open when? On the
weekend? We're open every Saturday and Sunday from 11 to 4, and we docent from 11 to 3, which doesn't mean I haven't left here at 4 o'clock. If we're really busy, I stay and as long as I can docent.
Best idea would be, if you're interested in the Adobe, come out on a weekend. Yep. Come out and tour the place. See if you like it. If you'd like to become a volunteer docent, there's so much. In fact, this is one of the few places I say the regular docents have a great deal of impact on the, it's not like the management tells them what to do. Oddly enough, it's the reverse. And all of our best ideas, like the Rose Garden and others, have come from the bottom. Docents doing it and suggesting it, and the city following their lead.
That's
right. As opposed to just doing whatever they're told.
And what I failed to mention to you earlier is not quite almost every time that I work here, I meet an Olivas.
Ah.
And I met one at the Owl Festival. There was one here, and Gina says, Georgia, you got to meet him, you got to meet him. So I get the names and phone numbers, and he's going to find out how he's listed and who the grandparents are, and then I'm getting back to him. So I'm excited about that.
That's always exciting. Mm-hmm. And we tried to figure out how many descendants there were from Raimundo and Teodora, the couple that built the house. My nearest estimate is over 400.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think 2009 or 10, they had a Olivas Fiesta here. And my grandchildren were just probably 5 and 7. And we dressed them here, and my daughter was here and her husband. And I sat with 300 Olivas. Some of them were married to an Olivas, but a lot of them were direct descendants. That was exciting, under the big maple tree there.
I'd like to thank you, Georgia, Maria Olivas Madrid.
Thank you for that.
For all of your names here.
Yes.
And thank you very much for taking time out of your busy day to introduce us to this special place here in Ventura.
Thank you. I'm blessed to be here with you, too.
Thank you. We'll be right back with more of our special episode at the Olivas Adobe in Ventura. This brings us to the end of another episode of About Town. I'd like to thank the Olivas Adobe Volunteer Docents for all that they do to keep this place alive. We have a lot of different things going on. Of course, I should also thank the owls for coming every year to lay their eggs and hatch their young right here at the Adobe. Thank you. And of course, thank you for tuning in and watching another episode of About Town. To learn about more of what I do, check out my website at richardserrett.com. And of course, you can also check me at the City of Ventura, where we have in the guidebook all sorts of tours and events that I lead throughout the city and throughout the year. Thank you once again. This is Richard Serrett, signing off at the Olivas Adobe.